Hi guys, in this video I'm showing transnasal adenoid resection. That is adenoidectomy by transnasal transfer. Adenoid is hypertrophied mass of lymphatism which is situated in the nasal pharynx, in the roof of the nasal pharynx. It is pink and globular in shape as you can see in endoscopy. The hypertrophy is mainly because of chronic inflammation, either by infection or allergies. Clinically, if you see these patients classically having adenoid facies, characterized by sunken eyes, narrow pinched nostril, open mouth, high arch palate, crowded teeth, dull mask-like face, drooling saliva, and inverted upper lip. If you see, these are more breathers, dry mouth, persistent runny nose, snoring OSA, and these patients having frequent sinus and ear infection, sometimes having cardiopulmonary complication, mainly pulmonary hypertension or cold pulmonary. These patients classically present by adding nasal obstruction and persistent running nose. These, the blood supply for adenoid is by ascending palatine artery, ascending pharyngeal artery and pharyngeal branch of third maxillary artery. The lymphatic drainage of this adenoid mainly by level 2 retropharyngeal and parapharyngeal lymph node. These venous drainage by pterygoid venous plexus. Classically, you can diagnose these cases by X-ray adenoid or neck lateral view, and gold standard is nasal endoscopy. You can see in nasal endoscopy absolute or relative adenoid hypertrophy, and clinically you can see patient having classical adenoid facies, and you have to operate by microdebrider transnasal approach or transoral approach or coblation adenoidectomy. It doesn't matter either method, both method are very nice. You can operate by any means, but it should be removed completely. In the old era, whatever we are operating by cold steel method without seeing it, I don't think we were able to remove complete adenoid during that era. So today we have to see and resect. That is best method. So transnasal adenoid resection is best method to operate the adenoid tissue. As you can see, I am operating by 0 degree transnasal endoscopic, and I am using adenoid bend through transoral approach. So both transnasal and transoral route can be used. You can see transnasal 0 degree endoscope or by 70 degree transoral endoscope, but you have to resect adenoid completely by any means. So both microdebrider and coblator are best method. It doesn't matter whatever you are using, but it should be completely removed. So I am using coblation. You can see there is only mucosa is left, rest adenoid is resected. I am doing this by coblator bed, so there is only mucosa there. The complete adenoid resection is possible by this tonsil, this adenoid bend by coblation method. So view and see and resect the adenoid is if required in patient. Right now we have patient up to 25 years of age. Because of food habits and allergies, adenoid may enlarge up to 25. Normally it disappears after 14 years of age. So complete adenoid resection is compulsory. There is no recurrence. Only recurrence you have done partial surgery. So in adenoid there is wonderful result if you resecting 100%. So adenoid resection, transnasal or transoral approach is very nice, so you have to operate accordingly. So these are the best method whatever we are using in adenoid. So this is all about adenoid. You can see the adenoid or nasal endoscopy just like I am seeing the sunset from my roof of my home. You can see this wonderful adenoid is seeing in transnasal endoscopy, just like I'm seeing the sunset from my roof in Motera. So this wonderful sunset I'm seeing from my rooftop. Thank you so much.